Today I'm going to do quick engine temperature sensor replacement, and we're going to replace the single wire sensor. Honda calls that sensor temperature sending unit, which wire it straight to the instrument cluster temperature gauge. There is another one on the back near the thermostat housing. That's a cooling fan switch. That's a different sensor which turns on and off your radiator electric cooling fans. I'm going to use a Beck & Arnley. There's a part number. I got it for $12 from the local parts store. Yeah, let's get started. Put a new sensor. Okay, first let's unplug our connector. And this video is only demonstration. I'm going to do the quick replacement. Yeah, normally you have to drain the coolant, but I'm not going to do that. Okay, yeah, my cooling system is full, and it will lose a little bit coolant, not big of a deal. And I'm going to put a catching pan underneath. Yeah, it will spill a little bit and we'll catch the coolant. All right, let's put a Teflon tape, make sure our new sensor won't leak. Yeah, simply that. And going to use a half inch socket for the new sensor, but our old sensor is 12 mil. Yeah, let's remove the old sensor. And yeah, if you have any questions, leave them down in the comment section below. Critics, comments, suggestions. Yeah. Okay. I got my engine coolant temperature sensor loose. Just put in a paper towel underneath. Just prevent it from leaking. All right, sensor is out. And yeah, now I'm putting a new one. Yeah, a little bit of coolant came out. Yeah, I'm starting the sensor by hand, few threads, and then let's tie it up with a wrench. By the way, diagnostic troubleshooting video will be down in the description while we're replacing this sensor. Yeah, over time, those thermistors, they go bad and they're worn out. Yeah, okay. I'll wipe the coolant, what was spilled. Let's connect our electrical connector. The yellow and green wire is going to the instrument cluster temperature gauge. Okay, all clean. Very little coolant we lost. Yeah, pretty much nothing. Yeah, we did it fast. And plug that hole with a paper towel, make sure it won't spill much. Okay, yeah, now we have to purge the whatever air can get into the cooling system. I will put a video down in the description how to purge the air from the engine cooling system. It's pretty easy, check it out. Okay, yeah, we'll look for leaks, make sure we don't have any, and get out of that air, make sure our system is purged properly, otherwise you might have the incorrect readings. And yeah, something like that. Pretty simple, pretty easy. Yeah, temperature sensor is functioning properly, gauge is working. Yeah, thank you so much guys for your time watching this video. If you like it, if it's helpful, thumbs up. And yeah, keep your old reliable Honda CR-V on the road, and this vehicle won't ever let you down. Take care of your old Honda and they will go forever. See you soon. Bye-bye.